It has been a rough year so far, so I thought, let's just sit down together and watch some skincare TikToks. Let's see what's going on that side of the internet. We're going to look at some cringeworthy mistakes that we can both laugh and giggle at, but we're also going to talk about some skincare trends and products, and I'm gonna help break down from a medical esthetician's perspective whether or not they're a good buy, whether or not they would work for you, or who they might be okay for. You beautiful butterflies have been tagging me in this nonstop. You said, don't watch, just react. So that's what we're doing.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I got it at CVS. You can probably get it at Walgreens, Target, things like that. It's called the hydrocolloid bandages. There it is. For fingers, toes, and heels. And now chins. Pack of 6, 2 different sizes for $6. Really easy to find just by the pharmacy area under Band-Aids.
I did not check to see if it was dermatology approved. I didn't even read reviews on it. I just wanted to give it a shot, and I mean, it worked. It definitely got stuff out clearly in the video and the pictures, but it wasn't like the safest thing on my face. More red, more itchy, peeling a lot more, very, very dry. So I just kept adding lotion and just keeping the spot clean. Let's get up close and personal to the blemish itself. You can still see it's red. I can actually still see it. I can feel it. Like, I feel something in there for sure. I'm not gonna put another Band-Aid on though because my skin finally healed itself.
Your skin is smart. Let it take care of you. My first impression to this is, ooh, sis, that's a cyst. Cysts are these large growths underneath the skin. Think of them like a grape. You have a little bit of an outer skin, the grape skin, and then you have the gushy stuff inside. And sometimes that is keratin, sometimes that is like pussy fluid. It depends on the type of cyst or, you know, what is causing it. Now, based on the amount of fluid that looked like a cyst, maybe it popped under there. The only thing is that she did mention in the second video that she was applying lotion. Hydrocolloid bandages really hold on to moisture, but if she had been cleaning it and putting moisturizer or lotion on the skin and then putting the Band-Aid, were we seeing that product being absorbed? I'm not sure. The fact that she still felt something under there makes me think it was a cyst. I hope that her skin is doing well. And again, hydrocolloid patches, they are the little pimple patches that you see. If it's just hydrocolloid, they're mainly the same. If you turn and learn those ingredients and see that some have hydrocolloid patches with salicylic acid, that's an actual acne-fighting ingredient. You know that the ones that I love are Zitstica. They're not just hydrocolloid patches, but they have micro darts. They have like niacinamide, salicylic acid, and tea tree oil that actually penetrates into the skin and like dissolves a pimple. So those are slightly different. But if you're looking for just a basic hydrocolloid patch that absorbs stuff off the skin, yeah, she used the Band-Aid brand. They have some good ones. There are some other medical brands that, you know, are just like more generic. And yeah, they work. This morning, you were blowing up my phone with this one as well. So let's see what's happening. And also, you guys, if you don't have TikTok, if you're not following me, if you don't want to download it or don't have it in your country, that is another reason that we do these videos. I explore the TikTok side of the internet so that you don't have to. But if it is downloaded, if you want to send me your skincare routine, or if you want to come say hi, I'm at Cassandra Bankson. Feel free to do so.
At Walmart with Dad, and I was looking at skincare stuff, and I couldn't decide what I wanted or what I needed, and he says, we're gonna get this. He said, this is what I used to use as a teenager, and it burns your face off. And I was like, I don't want that. He's like, that's what you need.
At first I thought it was mouthwash. It says skin something. Just because it burns doesn't mean it's working, but let's actually see what happens.
So, we're gonna see if it burns my face off. Okay, here we go. Oh, it's burning. Oh yeah, it's burning. Uh-huh. Oh my god.
This looks like a pure astringent, or perhaps it's a scaling solution. These are usually pure alcohol. They can be very stinging to the skin, especially she has a couple of blemishes. I know the feeling of like trying to just burn off your face. Just because it hurts doesn't mean it works better. Normally, you want to avoid that. So yes, I'm sure this could dry out a pimple. This is definitely an archaic way of going about things. Oh my god, I was right. It's a pure astringent. Oh my god, it's only $3 $4 at Walgreens. See, she opened the video with, "I went to Walmart with my dad." We knew it was all going downhill from there. Again, you can't tell everything from an ingredients list, but if you've worked in cosmetic chemistry or if you understand these things, you can get kind of a feel, or it's, you know, your first inclination of a product. Yeah, this is water and denatured alcohol. Camphor, which sometimes is okay, but very, very drying. Fragrance, which can be irritating. Ooh, clove leaf oil can be irritating. Ooh, eucalyptus, benzoic acid. Oh, no, no, no. The only soothing, sensitive, skin-friendly ingredient in here is glycerin. This is basically denatured alcohol. If you want to get some isopropyl alcohol, denatured alcohol, just rub it all over your face. That's basically what this is. Yes, it can burn, especially open wounds. You know, it can help to clean the skin, like, you know, before we do a blood draw. But yeah, you don't need to put this on your face. We have an unedited retinol experience. I love a good glow up. You guys tag me in this nonstop.
So this is me before my retinol burn. And this is me now. Educate yourself before using retinol. Help me, Hiram!
Oh, if Hiram hasn't seen this, can we, you know what, I'm just gonna like send this to him. That is very concerning. Yes, that looks like a retinol burn. I wonder if it was retinol, retinoic acid, if it was over the counter or prescription strength. Most people don't have this reaction, but this is why it's important to patch test. And then also, did she go into the sun? This almost looks like, from what I can see from the video, almost looks like hyperpigmentation. You know, it definitely looks like a burn. So how many days has this been? Has it been 3 weeks in which it is deep set hyperpigmentation, or is this just something that happened yesterday and it's still, you know, the burnt off skin? Yeah, definitely concerning. And this is also why, you know, patch test, talk to your derm, follow manufacturer's instructions.
You know what we don't like? Copyright strikes or shitty commercials. These are chia seeds. Don't put them on your cheeks. You better not buy from this commercial.
Literally, they're just putting product on, putting like chia seeds on the face, or like, I don't know, crunched up leaves, tea leaves, wiping it off and applying a filter in editing. Who is buying this? This has thousands, hundreds of thousands of views and comments of people asking for this. I just don't understand. This is also what irks me. Look at the people that they're using. These people have textured skin. They have acne scars. These are things that some people feel very insecure about. So the manufacturers of this are obviously preying on these people's insecurities. If someone can help me find, you know, a link with the ingredients, because they don't have the ingredients for this, please let me know. We'll dig it apart, or we'll try it. I think 208 Skin Doc even tried it. Yeah, Dustin gave it a go. This is just not okay. These things bother me. And yeah, don't fall for them. It looks like mint chip ice cream. Look at that. Ew, it looks like mint chip. Kind of hungry. You kept tagging me in this one as well and saying, don't watch, just react. So here we go.
I just want to make sure I can do my skin here. You can do your skincare.
Skincare.
Oh. Maybe tomorrow, but you'll just have to see how you're feeling,
girl. Yeah, that's the biggest thing.
What?
You're just going to have to see how you're feeling tomorrow.
Oh. Can I do skincare tonight?
No.
No skincare tonight. I can't wash my face! Okay. you can. You can?
Yeah, you can.
I thought you meant do it on other people.
No, I don't care about you. I want my skincare. I want my skincare. I've been doing a 10-step routine.
She does a 10-step routine every night.
Like, so I'll stay looking young. How old did you think?
Yeah, what did you think? I probably thought you were like 23, 24. But you're 25, right?
Shit, it's not working.
Oh my god, that is dedication. A 10-step skincare routine. You know that it is not a routine, but a ritual. You have to use it in order for it to work. She knows regularity. Someone has done their homework. She's obviously getting her wisdom teeth removed, which can be painful. You were put on lots of meds, and when you come off of the anesthesia, you know, you get a little bit loopy. The dedication, though. The dedication.
I found a St. Ives face mask in my sister's room. I'm gonna put 100 layers on my face. Let's go.
There's a problem.
Why does it say deep? Let's go. If I don't break out from this, I'm a god.
Layer 1, layer 5,
Layer 7. Layer 10. 11. My lips are burning and I got it in my freaking eye. 15. Got it out of my eye. Thank God. 25. Layer 35. Finally at 50 and I can barely move my face.
Oh yeah, and I had an allergic reaction that lasted 3 days and I could barely see and my face was so red, I literally looked like a tomato.
80. 90. Only 10 more to go. 100. I'm gonna let dry and take it off camera. But
God! This is a product that goes on the knees, on the feet. It was a try and discard. Her sister is probably a lovely person, but needs help with those skincare choices. And why would you put on 100 layers? Especially if it's burning. Yeah, if something is majorly burning and it's not something like a chemical peel that you've patch tested and know how to use, maybe don't do it. Oh, I cry for her skin. And I also want to know whether or not she broke out because, as she mentioned, if she didn't, she's a god. You guys have been tagging me in this next one nonstop as well.
Let me show you the most natural face cleanser that comes straight from a tree. So Qasil is a beauty ingredient native to Somalia and is known as one of the most purest face cleansers around. It's 100% natural, straight from nature, and is amazing for all skin types. It can treat skin conditions like acne, dark spots, hyperpigmentation, and can help you maintain clear and healthy skin. All you do is mix the powder with some water applied on the skin and massage the skin in circular motion for about 1 to 2 minutes. The more you massage the skin, the more it starts to firm up and lathers like a normal soap. This one ingredient cleanser is pH balanced, moisturizing, and is enriched with amazing nutrients to maintain clear and healthy skin. Qasil is also known to be the secret beauty ingredient that Somali women have been using for centuries in their beauty rituals.
It definitely seems interesting. This was posted from a branded account, so are they biased? Maybe. I actually don't know much about this at all. Qasil or Qasil, if it's been used in Somalia for thousands of years, that makes sense. Again, there are ingredients that have been used by cultures, by indigenous tribes, etc., that work. And, you know, if someone's been doing that, if it's a part of a ritual for them, if it's part of, you know, something that is their culture or their identity, and they love it for their skin, keep using it. But I have not seen this before. It is interesting. There is no medical data to back up these claims. For instance, getting rid of acne or hyperpigmentation. I would be very skeptical about that. Again, just because there aren't studies doesn't mean it doesn't work. It means that someone hasn't paid for them. But based on where it's from, I think it's from the Goa tree, I don't think it would destroy the skin. But compared to other cleansers that are available, we have such advanced cosmetic formulas. Like, if you want to go rub avocado and oats and bananas onto your skin, go for it. But it's not going to do much. Why not use a cleanser or a mask that's actually formulated to help out, you know, your skin's natural barrier, your acid mantle, etc., you know, as opposed to using things like this. It does look cool and foamy and green, but this is something I am not very familiar with. If you've ever tried it, leave a comment. I'm interested in learning more. Now, this next one, I have tried.
This mask? I promise to always be honest with you guys. I actually got this mask for free. I'm obsessed with it. Mainly because it makes me look like I am the third member of Daft Punk. But also because it's supposed to be doing really good things for my skin. There's three colors. It's an LED light mask. Here's the box. I got it from DMH Aesthetics. The different lights do different things to your face. Now I just look like David Dobrik. I don't know why I look like this. Okay. So it says on the box, red for inflammation, blue for acne, amber for discoloration. And I'm obsessed with it. It's just kind of like one of those fun things that you do in your house when you're alone and you're watching TV. Sometimes I also like to wear it out and about just to scare people. Like I'll wear it to walk to get coffee and people are like, But I like to keep my neighborhood interesting, you know what I mean? I would do literally anything for good skin, and the fact that I can get good skin and look so cool at the same time, chef's kiss.
That is hilarious, and honestly, pandemic safe with a mask underneath, I would probably be down to like wear one of those in public. The thing I have to say, LED is a therapy that has been proven to work. We have medical data that supports it, but the light has to be at a very specific wavelength. It needs to penetrate into the skin and actually work, and it needs to be strong enough to do that. What we use in a dermatology clinic, you can actually control the power so you can really get it into the skin, and you have to wear glasses and goggles to protect your eyes. I am very skeptical of over-the-counter stuff. If it is not sold with goggles or glasses, is it actually strong enough to work? The only over-the-counter product that I've used, personally recommend, and also Dr. Dre recommends and uses, which I found out like a week ago on Instagram, it was so validating, it's the Light Stim for acne or for wrinkles. Those are the only two I know of. They actually have the LEDs, the light emitting diodes that have little bulbs that can actually, you know, press to the skin and they disperse the light. They are at the right wavelengths. Things like this just make me skeptical. And if you take a look, they don't look like LED bulbs. They look like LED strips. And I feel like those strips aren't doing enough, you know, to actually penetrate light into the skin. And again, if you have your eyes open, is it really strong enough to be working? If she's seen results, that's great, but is it placebo effect? Is it really working? Did you change 5 other things in your skincare routine and you're seeing benefits from those products as opposed to this device? I don't know. I also don't know how expensive this one is. I haven't tried this exact one. I tried a similar one. Yeah. If you want an actual review or if you want a video, you know, going in a COVID safe manner to, you know, get like a drive-through Starbucks or something, let me know.
After doing the condiment makeup challenge on my face, my skin is finally breaking out. So it really seems like the perfect time to go ahead and try another face mask. This one's called the Zombie Pack. And apparently it's supposed to be really similar to the Hanacure mask I did. I think we all know how that turned out. This one is a lot cheaper on Amazon, so let's go ahead and find out how it works. So for $18, I got 8 of these, plus the little paintbrush. One of the Hanacures was like $35 or $40. I am cheap as shit, so this is already better in my mind. Here's the powder. Oh! It smells like straight up bleach. So now I'm gonna mix this into this, and we'll see what happens. By the way, I use this to mix it together. You can't tell me this doesn't look like the broken end of a plastic fork. It's so fancy. Here I am mixing it together. It's ready! What is this? You guys.
Wait, we don't get to see the other part. That looks painful. Oh, that looks painful. Who wants like a review of the Hanacure mask? Let me know because I've been interested in trying it. I have to check if it's cruelty free. This does look scary. These are these tightening masks. If someone wants to grab the ingredients, honestly, I'm too lazy at this point. I can't with the way this first week of 2020 has been. You know, stress impacts your skin. I've been breaking out. The hair has fallen out. It's a stressful time. Getting through it, but like, my God. We need skincare to be self-care. We need it right now. And this just looks painful. I know that these can get cracky on the skin. Let me know the ingredients and I'll look into it for you. But my initial off the bat reaction is no. Then you guys also continue to tag me in this one. You say, don't watch, just react. So let's do it. No, we're done. We're done. No. I feel like I have things going through my head about that last one. Yeah, but my answer is absolutely no. I don't recommend. Where did someone get this idea? Are you guys confusing this for the Ordinary's AHA BHA peeling solution? Like, did you just see the visual and just like connect two things that should not be connected? Don't do it. That is advice you should never take from the internet if I have ever seen it. There's a lot of bad advice on the internet, which is why I always say it is not a library, it is a dumpster. If you want actual advice, I have a couple of TikToks that I've posted. Again, feel free to send me your routines if you want a little bit of help. And if you don't have TikTok, that's why we react to these, so that you can learn from other people's mistakes and not do them. And we have a whole bunch of YouTube videos as well, talking about different skincare routines, different practices, different products and brands to help you make the right decisions that let you feel empowered by your skin and take care of it. Because remember, it takes care of you. If you haven't subscribed or hit the notification bell, do so before the world ends. Who knows? This might be your last chance. Don't want to miss it. But overall, remember to be beYoutiful both inside and out. I love you and I cannot wait to see you in this other TikTok reaction video. Love you guys. Bye.